Hi, my name is Emre Yildirim, a PhD student at the University of Manchester. It is Friday the 10th of December and this is your Fusion News Update. Today's stories include: 1. Nuclear fusion startup lands $1.8 billion as investors chase star power. 2. Bezos-Backed General Fusion raises $130 million for Reactor. 3. Shaping up nicely, adjusting the plasma edge can improve the performance of a star on Earth. And there are obviously some bonuses for you at the end too. Now, our first story today. Nuclear fusion startup lands $1.8 billion as investors chase star power. Now, this is our biggest story today, but also one of our biggest stories to date. And that is that $1.8 billion has been invested in the American company Commonwealth Fusion Systems. This latest round of funding was led by Tiger Capital, but also involved big names such as Bill Gates and ex-oil giants Equinor, showing the appetite in the energy sector to really get involved with fusion. Commonwealth Fusion Systems' first demonstration plant is set to be completed by 2025, with them being one of a few promising companies following the tokamak design. It is hoped that this reactor will yield a Q factor of 2, where the energy output is double that of the energy input. A related piece is in Reuters entitled "Any Ready to Spend More on Nuclear Fusion in Green Drive?" And this is about the energy company Eni from Italy, describing the fact that they're investing more in Commonwealth Fusion Systems this time around, again adding to that appetite shown within the energy sector. Now, this investment into Commonwealth Fusion Systems followed the one that we previously reported on in TE Systems and in Helion Energy, and it just really shows how fusion investment is really starting to heat up. A really exciting decade is coming up for many fusion companies, and these kind of investments is the only way to get them there. 2. Bezos-Backed General Fusion raises $130 million for Reactor. Now, we have more investment into the fusion energy sector here, with $130 million being raised by General Fusion, a Canadian company. These funds were raised mainly from Sagard Capital Management, the Business Development Bank of Canada, and some family hedge funds, and of course, Jeff Bezos. General Fusion plans to build its first demonstration power plant at the Cullum Centre for Fusion Energy near Oxford in the UK. Their device is scheduled to begin operation in 2025, similar to Commonwealth Fusion Systems. General Fusion uses a different kind of approach called magneto-inertial fusion, which involves the use of well-timed hydraulic pistons to compress a liquid metal wall surrounding a plasma to generate the conditions required for fusion. Having multiple investment stories within just 1 week into such varied projects shows the health of the fusion industry as a whole, and it really means that 2025 is heating up to be a really exciting year for both of these companies and for the sector as a whole. Now for a little bit of academic news from the public ventures. Collaborators from the Princeton Plasma Physics Laboratory and the Max Planck Institute for Plasma Physics found that injections of boron carbide managed to cool off areas in the plasma, increasing the density in other areas, leading to far better plasma performance. The team was working on Wendelstein 7X, a type of fusion concept called a stellarator. Boron coatings are widely used to cover the interior of tokamaks and stellarators to prevent the metals and other heavy elements from leaching from the walls into the plasma. But the coatings wear away over time, and the researchers wanted to find a way to repair the coatings on the wall while the fusion reaction is still going on. Continuous operation will be important for a power plant. It was found when dropping controlled amounts of boron carbide into the top of the plasma, just like salt from a shaker, they saw that the temperature of the plasma went up. Now, this was a surprising result, and they found it's because the edge of the plasma started to cool, increasing the density gradient across it, and therefore heating up the plasma within. Now, they found this is a really exciting result because increasing the temperature of the plasma is going to give huge benefits to efficiencies. Now for some bonuses: nuclear fusion and the race to save the planet with gas hotter than the sun. This article from The Times follows Tokamak Energy in their search for fusion power. It also involves insight from other UK-based players such as First Light Fusion. A really great line from it comes as: "Many of the hottest places in the solar system are found in a corner of Oxfordshire." A really incredible and exciting thing to think about, and it just shows the massive challenge that we have on our hands, but also the wonderful scientific achievement it will be. Nuclear fusion, why the race to harness the power of the sun just sped up. The Financial Times has a big read on fusion energy. Now, this involves mainly First Light Fusion, the UK-based company I mentioned earlier, but also involves discussions around fusion energy as a whole and other companies such as General Fusion, Helion Energy, and TE Technologies. Now for our final bonus. This is a plug for our Fusion News Extra podcast, in which we do some deep dives with some of the people from the stories that we discuss here on the channel. In this one, we chat with Dr. Annie Kritcher from NIF about their record fusion energy gain that they found in their most recent batch of experiments. Check that one out on all of the good podcast platforms out there. That's it for me today. Thank you all so much for watching. Don't forget to like and subscribe, and I'll see you all very soon.